brother. What's up?
This is a Cuban party, man.
Yeah,
I
brother,
can dig
like
it.
Life's great. You gonna entertain there, huh?
Yes.
Absolutely. Say it again, y'all.
I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. So good. So good. I got to hear. I feel nice. A sugar and spine. I feel nice. A sugar and spine. So nice. So nice. I got you. We'll be right back.
like being there with thousands and thousands of men and just a couple of girls.
I felt like a big sister, and it made me feel good to see just a little bit more happiness in their lives, especially for that day. They was down in the dumps. They wanted to see somebody from home, and it seemed like we all just made them light up. So I felt very good about the whole thing.
Tell them about the plane.
On our first day in Saigon, we're getting ready to go up. We're all excited, you know. We want to go. We want to get to the troops real quick.
There,
you
right.
know. So we hear the guns, you know. Oh, okay. We're going up. It looks good. And all of a sudden, someone says, we got to bail out. The motor's on fire. Oh, why did the man say that? Everybody's froze.
I don't know why he said
it. Everybody froze up, but they did make a landing. And boy, everybody flew out.
Funny thing, I really felt like you'd been there.
Funny thing, I tried to get Clay to tell a joke.
Hey, how about that? Yeah, I'm gonna tell one outside.
Yeah. But, Mr.
Well,
Brown.
Well, then I knew you could run and fast, you could dance, really.
But I must admit, I was the only girl there, you know, eight of us, mm-hmm. right? But Mr. Brown was a gentleman all the way, and he stood right there then, and when I jumped off, he caught me, and we ran together.
A lot of running going on.
Yeah, well, that's one of the most important things of right now. Running.
Yes, I think that's right.
Comfort the people who may not never see these people again. And if the music is loud enough, like we did, we had a ceasefire for the time that I was on the stage. They didn't use that time to blow the place. Everybody wanted to come hear the music.
We did two, sometimes three shows a day. It was harder than any tour I'd ever done. We traveled the country by helicopter and came back to our Saigon hotel every night. In those days, the singers who traveled with me were also my girlfriends. That way, I could keep them with me. In Vietnam, Marva Whitney was the singer in my show.
I was scared to death, and especially in the planes when they, every now and then, we could kind of peep out the window, and it's something to look up, down, and all you see is fire. Fire. And then they tell you you have to lay down in the belly of the plane. So we laid down. We were very obedient because we didn't want to get shot. And I think he felt comfortable if he had at least a stick to fight in case somebody came. And he said, I must have a stick to protect myself. I was very glad that he did.